Today we will start the geography chapter 2, Inside Our Earth. Before starting the chapter, I would ask you about the structure of the earth. How it looks, our earth? Our earth is having a spherical shape. So what do you understand by spherical shape? That means if we take an example of an onion, it looks like this, spherical in shape, okay? Or you can say as spheroid, okay? Another name is being given, that is spheroid. So we are taking this onion an example as of earth, okay? So when we cut this onion, what we see? Can you see here? We see different layers, okay? So in the same way, our structure of the earth is spherical and we have different layers inside the earth. So today we will be going to study about the structure of the earth and what is inside the earth. It is seen that the earth is divided into three concentric layers, that is crust, mantle and core. That is concentric, that is in a circle way, it is divided into three layers. The most important, it is the core, that is the middle part, then we have the mantle and the outermost layer is the crust. So we'll be dealing with each layer in detail. Crust. The crust is the solid outermost layer. So this one, this uppermost layer of the earth is called as the, what it is called? It is called as the crust. And it is also called as the lithosphere, that is the land area, okay? So the crust is also called as the lithosphere. It is relatively thin layer, that means the crust is relatively thin than core and the mantle, that means the crust is literally thinner, it is not thick, okay? It is thinner than all other layers of the earth. The upper part of the crust is called as the continental crust, that is the uppermost part of the earth is called as the continental crust, which is 35 kilometer thick, okay, 35 kilometer thick. And the lower part is called as the oceanic crust, okay? The lower part is called as the oceanic crust, which is only 5 kilometer thick, okay? So what it is? It is, the crust is having two types of layers, that is continental crust and oceanic crust. The continental crust is 35 kilometer thick and oceanic crust is 5 kilometer thick. The continental crust is made up of silica and aluminia, and thus it is called as the what? Sile. Okay. And the oceanic crust is made up of silica and magnesium, and therefore it is called as the sima, or you can say the main mineral constituents of the continental mass are silica and aluminia, which is called as the sile. So sile, SI for silica, and AL is aluminia. The oceanic crust mainly consists of which are the minerals? Silica and magnesium. So therefore it is called as the sima. So you can understand, remember, SI for silica and Ma for magnesium. And the crust consists of soil and it provides us with most of the minerals. That means the land surface or the outermost layer of the earth, that is crust, it consists of soil and it provides us with minerals. Now moving to the mantle, that is, it is just lies between the crust and the core, that is, it is in the middle part. Okay, this is the core, that is the innermost, outermost. Here it is the mantle, and the here we have the crust. So this part we are talking about, the mantle region of the earth. It is just beneath the crust, that is, it is just beneath the, this is the crust, it is just beneath the crust, this is the mantle, and it has a thickness of 2900 kilometer thick. So it is 2900 kilometer thick. Okay, the mantle, it has thickness of 2900 kilometer and it is called as the mantle. It is made up of dense and heavy materials such as iron and magnesium. So what it is made up of? It is made up of dense and heavy materials such as iron and magnesium. And here in the mantle, the temperature is very high and magma is found in this layer. So where is magma found? Magma is found in the mantle region or layer. Now moving to the core, that is the innermost layer of the earth. The core lies below the mantle and around the center of the earth, that is the middle core. Inside we have talked about, or we have seen in the diagram, that is the core. Here the innermost or inside center of the earth, it is the core. It is called as the barosphere. The average radius of the core is about 3500 kilometers. So what is the radius, or you can say the thickness of the core? That is 3500 kilometers. It is made up of heavy metals such as nickel and iron. Therefore, it is called as the NIF. So, core consists of heavy metals, which we call it as a NIF, because it consists of which minerals? Nickel and iron. Okay, Fe, that is called as ferrous, which is also been called as the iron. And the core is having the highest temperature. Okay, the temperature of this layer varies between 2200 degrees Celsius to 5000 degrees Celsius. Can you imagine the temperature inside the earth is very intense and very high? It can melt anything. And which are the materials or the metals which are found in the core? That is nickel and iron. And it is all about the innermost, and it is the innermost and very intense, having a high temperature. So we have dealt about the structure of the earth, and in that structure we have dealt about the three layers of the earth. That is, we have dealt about the crust, mantle and core. So we will be moving to other areas also. That on the earth crust we have the rocks and materials. So we can say we have talked about the outermost layer of the earth, that is the crust, and that crust is also called as the lithosphere. So what is there? The lithosphere is made up of rocks and minerals. So we have seen that the lithosphere is made up of rocks and minerals. So rocks are those materials which are obtained from the earth's crust, that is found on the lithosphere. So what we can say, what is the definition of the rock? A rock is an any natural occurring solid mass or aggregate of minerals. So what is that? A rock is any natural occurring solid mass or aggregate of minerals. It can be of different color, size and texture. We have seen it also that the rocks is having a different colors, size and texture, and their chemical composition also varies. Okay, it is not the same. So we can say that there are three major types of rocks: igneous rock, sedimentary rock and metamorphic rock. So today we will deal with all the three, not all the three rocks, but at least one rock. First one is the igneous rock, second one is the sedimentary rock and metamorphic rock. Moving to the igneous rock. Igneous rock, the word igneous has been derived from the Latin word igneous meaning fire. Okay, the word igneous has been derived from the Latin word igneous meaning fire. The igneous rock is associated, or you can say this is formed due to the volcanic eruption. Okay, this rock is formed because of the volcanic eruption. They are formed when magma cools down and solidifies. Okay, and the rocks were the first to be formed, and thus it is also known as the primary rocks. So when the molten magma cools, it becomes solid, are called igneous rock, and they are associated with volcanic eruption. That means the igneous rocks are formed because of the volcanic eruption. When the volcanic erupts, what happens? The magma flows out, it solidifies, and that solidified rock is called as the igneous rock. And it is also called as the primary rocks. Now moving to other areas that they are also called as the primary rocks. Igneous rocks are of two types. Okay, intrusive igneous rock and extrusive igneous rock. Okay, that means we have two types of rocks which are found in igneous rock. That is intrusive igneous rocks and extrusive igneous rock. It is extrusive here means when the molten lava comes on the earth's surface, it rapidly cools down and becomes solid on the crust. These rocks are called as extrusive igneous rock. That means when there is a volcanic eruption, okay, and it solidifies above the earth crust, that is called as extrusive igneous rock. They have a very fine granite grain structure. Okay, the areas you can say, what is the identification of igneous rock? They have a very fine grain structure. Example, it is the basalt. The Deccan Plateau is made up of basalt rock. So what is an example we can give? That is a basalt, that is the Deccan Plateau is made up of basalt rock, that is the extrusive igneous rock. Now moving to the intrusive. When the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth's crust, giving formation of solid rock are called the intrusive igneous rock. That means whatever the volcanic eruption has happened, but it cools down inside the earth crust, giving a formation of a very hard and a solid rock, is called as the intrusive igneous rock. They cool down slowly and they form a large grains, that means a big boulders of rocks. They are being formed inside the earth crust. Example, granite, grinding stones used to prepare. Granite is grinding stones used to prepare paste, powder of spices, and grains are made of granite. If If you have not understood, I will further explain what is intrusive and extrusive igneous rock. That means when there is a volcanic eruption, what happens? The magma flows up and it settles above the earth crust. This is the crust. Okay, this is the crust. So what happened when there is a volcanic eruption? The lava flows up and it solidifies on the surface of the earth crust. That is called as extrusive igneous rock. It forms, cools down and solidifies and forms a rock which is called as extrusive igneous rock. And what happens? Other areas, magma solidifies inside the earth crust. That means inside the earth crust, it solidifies. That is called as the intrusive igneous rocks. Okay, that means inside the earth crust, the magma solidifies and forms a rock. That is called as intrusive igneous rock. Now, moving to the other characteristics of igneous rocks. These rocks are hard and compact. These rocks do not occur in distinct beds or strata. These rocks do not have remains of animals or plants. So, in these three, what are the things that we have come to know about the igneous rock? That they are very hard and compact. That means closely to each other, all these stones. So, these rocks are hard and compact, and the rocks do not occur in distinct beds, not on the layers, okay, or strata. These rocks do not have remains of animals or plants because it is being formed by the volcanic eruption. These rocks do not allow water to penetrate through them. So what is the feature of the main feature? That it does not allow the water, these rocks does not allow the water to penetrate under the ground, or you can say the pass through them. Other types of rocks are formed from the igneous rock, and igneous rock is also called as the primary rock, and so it is called as it is the first rock which is being formed because of the volcanic eruption. Valuable minerals such as iron, gold, silver and aluminium are found in these rocks. So in these rocks, what are the minerals we found? We find iron, gold, silver and aluminium. So we have talked about the structure of the earth, inside what are the layers, then we have talked about the rocks, and in rocks we have talked about the igneous rock and the two types of rocks, that is the intrusive and extrusive igneous rock, and the characteristics of igneous rock. So in the next class, we'll be dealing with the sedimentary rocks and the characteristics of various rocks.